a legal excellence firm in London that can help you with all aspects of your legal work. If you are looking at immigrating to the United Kingdom, Stewart & Co. can help you to set up business, buy houses in the UK, and will deal with all your legal works from start to finish.
For all your general immigration work, we can help you with that as well. If you apply for any form of visa, whether student visas, settlement visas, marriage visas, or a child wanting to come to the United Kingdom to settle with the family, we can help you to achieve your goals.
Stewart & Co. Solicitors, a legal excellence firm specializing in conveyancing, immigration, litigation, family law, personal injury, licensing, no win, no fee. Contact us today at www.sk-solicitors.com.
Boy, Janno Seekers Restaurant.
That's why I'm not going to be in the Dimbal. Janno.
Domoro Seneata, Adiata, Topotoro, Fanankenda Mabigi. Luntan During, Tamala, Abeka Domoro Kijani. Adimanda Walade, Takawe Vigele, Anim Fananka Fadijan, Ikono Efa. Ekavaminako Pastry and in Bakery, Iko Fanan Bakalin. Bade lomba conference lomba workshop lomba ye fofé nilo dunya kono domoro betama nilom international o tiwoda number 1
amanke ba domolo janda man
e sa domo jang is ataria
ah wo mu kubandi
sa na ko sa futandi
e oto sa na ko be mu CKS restaurant
ndaba na janna mu yat ni manje do rombi jang
aban
CKS restaurant known for best quality food and customer satisfaction.
Communication, connectivity is everything. We ensure that the links never sleep. quantities and qualities, all in our data service, providing efficient, reliable voice and data service. We believe if you're not up to speed, then you're going backwards. Communications have to flow as fast as the speed of light. Whatever business you're in, having someone who understands your needs is critical. That is why we just don't offer you technology, we offer you solutions. Enjoy Gamcel's internet broadband anytime, anywhere. Your national operator, Gamcel, Yai Barom.
Alright.
Honey, did you remind him that the last time he sent the money, it was not enough to buy all the provisions?
Oh, sorry, I forgot to tell him.
Are you guys talking about money transfer to buy provisions?
Yes.
But don't you know about Baluwo?
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 What is Baluwo?
Baluwo is a service that your son can use to send provisions directly to you guys from the shop. And you don't have to worry about the exchange rate.
Tell me how Baluwo works.
It's very simple.
Just log on to baluwo.com and shop, or download the app on your phone. You can shop on the website or using the app to buy online basic products for your family and friends. With Baluwo, you decide what your money is spent on. Your money, your choice. Buy online products for your family and friends in the Gambia, Senegal, Nigeria, or Mali. Baluwo, better than sending money.
Thinking of owning your dream homes? EJ Investment is here for you. Secure our quality bungalows with 2, 3, or 4 bedrooms, or our story buildings, 3 or 4 to 5 bedrooms, at very affordable prices with flexible payment plans. At our Sanyang Seaview Estate, where you can enjoy the cool breeze with modern infrastructure such as taroots, covered drainage system, modern electrification with street lights, gated entrance with security posts, and social amenities such as gas station, shopping mall, medical clinic, park, schools, children daycare, and a lot more. Our dedicated team of professionals will keep the estate clean at all times, provide security and patrol team within the estate premises, install latest technologies such as CCTV, Wi-Fi, home network installation, solar panel, and power backup system. Also, check out for our additional home facilities and interior design service such as premium tiling, wall plaster, home landscape, fingerprint home lock, and a lot more. Visit our office at Senegambia Kololi Highway and get a free site visit tour, or contact us on 4464-838, WhatsApp us on 3259220, or you can visit our Facebook page or Instagram on EJ Investments. EJ Investments, we are first in properties.
Albaka.
Albaka, important.
Yo, nga transfer us to
you. Yeah, transfer us.
Ha, code ni nji.
Okay. What's up? Nsi la ID soto.
Ha, ha, sa soto. Sorry. Agada.
Bidan bro.
Albaka.
Mbaka.
Bara la service o tariya.
Ha, but no more.
Okay. To continue, please, and proceed.
Good afternoon, Mr. Chairman. Indeed, we are ready to proceed. Mr. Witness, may I remind you that you are still under oath? Interpretation, please.
Sedo hanimbi mbe hakino bulang lako yekali o menke hanimbi bo kali kilim lako
alhamdulillah ngalo.
Yes, I know.
Before the break you were telling us about your party being your group being taken to Mile 2 prison.
Jangni mbe tala dahala iba fo kanyini wato me ining alaka fo mulu samba Mile 2 kasola.
And 5 from amongst you were taken to the NIA in Banjul.
Mululu bali kono ye nanu bondali kono ye samba NIA la bunda to Banjul.
Ah, wolen to nyati.
That's the truth. Okay.
Do you recall how many of you were taken to Mile 2 prison?
Nga mera ne manyi nan tol mo wonu woro.
If I can remember properly, we were 26.
Are you able to give us their names?
faisin tolu fo ñeno ban
hanin tebe to fo no la katu
I cannot name them all, but I know some of their names. Please go ahead, tell us those you know.
Okay.
I know that the late
Lamaron was there.
Ibrahim Ajabang Benunjele.
Ibrahim Ajabang was there.
Kafu Bayo Benunjele.
Kafu Bayo was there.
And Alassane Biay.
And Alassane Biay.
And an other Ibrahim Jadama.
And Ibrahim Jadama.
And Maud Touré.
And Maud Touré.
Fatou Kamara.
Fatou Kamara.
Nogo Ndiaye.
Nogo Ndiaye.
Fatoumata Diawara.
Fatoumata Diawara.
And Maud Ame, is it Lamine Fatié?
And Lamine Fatié.
I
can recall this, but there are others that I have forgotten.
Bari ngalon ne dal nga mo moni woro silanum karamun to dindin do beje kabrin tata NIA ya te bula wala to amna murna mile 2.
I know that we were 26. There was one student, but when we got to mile 2, he was released.
No, Kabrin Tata NIA.
He went to NIA, he was released.
Then Ibrahim Jabang, Ibrahim Janko Sise Fanabegele. The late Ibrahim Janko Sise.
The late Ibrahim Janko Sise was also there.
Fanabegele, yes.
Okay. So the list you mentioned includes Kafu Bayo, isn't it?
Yeah, Kafu Bayo
from MBJ.
But Kafu Bayo was taken to the NIA.
Directly to Samba and Ibrahim Solo Sande.
Yes, and Ibrahim Solo Sande were taken directly to the NIA.
Okay. And Nogoi was also taken to the NIA.
Yeah, Nogoi from Samba NIA.
Ha, wale kato ya from Samba direct NIA.
Yes, he too was taken direct to the NIA.
Okay, good. Please proceed.
Whilst
at the Mile 2 prison.
Kabri and Samba Mile 2 prison.
When we were taken to the Mile 2 prison,
they
brought their dinner, but I was angry and I said I was not going to eat.
We
were there until I can say around 12 midnight.
In Atan Noma.
Then they came after us.
Yeah,
and they were taking us out from ourselves and boarding us onto a pickup.
Yes, Banjul, NIA headquarters.
And they took us to Banjul to the NIA headquarters.
Who was doing this?
I think it was the NIA officials because they came with that vehicle from that place.
Were they in uniform or in mufti?
Yeah, uniform only. My uniform.
No, they did not put on uniforms.
Did they appear to you that they were soldiers?
For you, kete fele kuni limu soldier or letibal.
Na londi mafuta oto katwi my uniform do.
I wouldn't know because they were not dressed in uniforms.
Proceed, please.
Sai, kabrin tolbe futata NIA.
When all of us got to the NIA,
ika munta kono ye paren kamale bembatun kanne.
It was as if they were prepared for us and only waiting for our arrival.
Because
during the discussion, one of them even said, "You have wasted our time since evening time. We are here waiting for you."
Alien Toran, isn't that what he said?
Abulatan na lefankato, kuma kanja wale fanyaka alien tora katu kabrin uraro ntolbeja manta adulato.
The passing call said a foul word, followed by that we really gave them a problem because they were there and they were unable to go to bed.
Thank you, Amy. Proceed.
Kabrin, you okay?
After they did that,
inila boss lebe sirim bunkono yembe na statement a killing.
They were seated inside with their boss and they took our statements one at a time.
Again?
Kabrin Futata?
The question is,
said
you had given statements at Mile 2 prisons.
Ha.
Yes.
Mile 2 kasola.
Ha. Kabrin Tata NIA Fana?
Yes, but when we got to the NIA also,
Yembele statement ale katonke killing.
They took our statements one at a time.
Killing.
One after the other.
Yeah. Then Kabrin yoke foi la kurata.
When they did that and they were finished,
Yemfintin Nambanta.
They brought us outside.
ya dati ikam mo commande killing killing.
They started calling us one by one.
Bari ika direction fula letade.
But they took two directions.
Isi dol samba buluba karola.
Others were taken to the right hand side.
Ye dol samba mara karola.
Others were taken on the left hand side.
Barinte ke balabado beje wonata sindala nabe kachala.
As for me, there was one fat man who came and sat by me.
Ayeni ninka kuma jamala.
He asked me many questions.
Na la okacha kono.
During the course of that discussion,
do konyeko.
One said to me,
na lo na jabi mena wale mandia ka tunte ka nyeko na konchi chisoro ra no wale exercise ka.
I think what I responded to him was what was not pleasing to him, because I told him that I was
exercising
my constitutional rights.
Akonyeko habari ntolka sojaro lipa jani fonke fa.
He said to me, yes, but we used to beat soldiers here until we kill them.
Anka wasi kenole.
I said to him, that can be.
Al simfana lipa nole fa lienfa.
You can beat me also and kill me.
But al tafula njanadi.
But he will not do it for the second time.
Akonyeka olefo.
And he said to me, is that what you are saying?
Nka olefo.
I said to him, that is what I am saying.
Akonyemuna tineka ofo.
He said to me, why are you saying that?
Nka intemanke soldier tintemo politician old.
I said to him, I am not a soldier, I'm a politician. And the entire world is watching to see what he will do to me.
I'll seem far knowledge.
You could kill me,
but
you will not do it twice. And today I think that is clear. I don't think they will do it for the second time. So after they took
that person, do you recognize him? Do you know his name?
Umari ya sutele wala faya tolonne ba.
Ala ya lo ma tolon bari na lo dal ke jangolen jamfama ay baloso to katun men beje be atele baloso to iti.
God knows I don't know him. I cannot recognize him, but he's a tall guy.
And he was the toughest man among all of them.
Yeah, anila fondin ke do fana beje.
And there was one young man among them.
Akafole ko molo samba.
As a person, he orders to take people away.
Ye mo be samba kateli pantele kita mo labauti lawanta mo samba la.
They took all of us away to beat them. I was the last person whom they took away.
Katunga lo membe kela wadali roti tumando benna be kacha mena na akakuma kongo membe unkayafo.
The reason for that, I think, because I was chatting with him and the words I was telling him.
Dola safanke ko ay balafa soto na kuotolo o ay bunya soto ntela karola le.
Sometimes he will pretend to have sympathy for me or show respect to me.
Na la kacha akono na osuta akono le tumandobe.
I can recognize that in his manners.
Fontele labanta na takoboe ko asamba jana yente samba buluba karola.
Until I was the last person, when the boy came for me, he told him.
Bari mante samba bunkolo de yente lipa bantale.
They took me towards the right side. They didn't take me inside the room. They beat me outside.
Bari fondinke omen fanae samba janabe samba la fanae nka chandi le domandi.
Because the young man who took me to that beating place, he also talked to me.
Bari fondinke do soto je men fangoe lipa roke.
There was one young man who did the beating.
Wala kuoka wa kuyata baki.
His affairs is incredible.
Katu wabu korontori nkamala ba fula nyo flag biara be podi na be podi mpodi na komi unisafu mwame ya lonko abe sewori na puka nisamba katambuti.
Looks as if he was hungry for me. He was jumping around saying this flag bearer.
Bawo natalo mimi freedom tella natalo beje bana bembulu.
Because the photograph on the Freedom newspaper is of his mind, and I was the one there with the banner.
Wala tina kafunye flag bearer katu yo natalo kuchandi mele ena ekona.
That was why he was calling me the flag bearer, because they showed me that photograph.
Ila boss fana ben no ma ba fula nyoko ibalo nale.
Their boss also was after me, telling me, you will know.
Ntebe jelo la mbe no ma.
I was laughing and following them.
Kabiri mfutata ikonyoko si bankoto.
When we reached the place, they told me to sit on the ground.
Ayo kabimbe jolo la mko ija wongansi ya lebe jambi.
I was still laughing and I said, today we will become like newly circumcised men, boys.
Ayensi ndi woleto.
He made me sit down.
Ayo junota.
He took a rope.
Ayo mbulo lusiti.
Tied my hands.
Kami wono balate ye flat bale dida komi yu ya concrete wono bala.
There was an iron piece which was embedded in the wall, just shaped like a U. They tied my two hands on that iron piece of iron.
I see Pani Julota.
He brought a bucket.
Aya bonka.
And poured the water on me.
Kabirin ko la ilaha illallah.
When I uttered Allah's name,
Abi Wurla Bafala La ilaha illallah Jang Ibalonal.
He was also shouting saying La ilaha illallah here, you will know.
Then ye liparo datilo watole.
Then that was when they started the beating.
Nati in lipafa batata.
When he beats me until he tires,
Do fanae na.
Another one will come.
Do fanae na lipa.
He too will come and beat me up.
Do you have any idea the instrument they used to beat you?
For ye have crossile, ibe lipa kan mum fem fason nela.
Ni moto fan belt bambandi molten kuntumalu kome men ye wolelta.
They took the fan belts, vehicle fan belts, and that was what they were using to beat.
And in do fanabe je doko esa for police or lanyon kojulo fanabe bulu.
They had one also which looked like a stick, as just like the ones the police have.
And in hose pipe bamba nimol fanabe bulu amanke busa kilintide.
And the strong hose pipes they had too. It was not just one kind of stick they had.
Wolbebe jele.
All of those were there.
But men labanta nala.
But the last one to come.
Wolali paro damante.
Not only his beating,
but when the parole in banning the role sambanyola,
but he was beating and insulting, cursing my mother at the same time.
In which language?
Angibato.
Woka for angale kaunta kamunufe for Nigeria no le mamudamba mami ya umugambia ndikata because suwa kamfu abukamani kakamfu akangale kaunta.
He was speaking in English. It looked like he was a Nigerian because he never spoke Mandinga or Wolof.
Nunga kamu akadia mnyame.
And his tone.
And in Nigerian old Kamole Kamulu.
He had the Nigerian accent.
And then Ala Liparo from Menjawata Jatikan Lipanun Kumolto.
And the worst part of his beating was the fact that he was beating me on my head. And that made my eye to swell so that I was unable to see.
Liparo mandimo menke na baribanendro en yokuyabaki.
The beating did not cause much body pain, but the causing the insults to my mother was what actually pained me a lot. And while they were taking me to be beaten, they took my shirt and they tied my face. They escorted me to the spot where I was beaten. And their boss, who was telling me, you will know,
Wole lote kunto.
He was standing there.
Akoya kala kanyanta ni wontal ba falal.
And he told them, stop, otherwise you would kill him.
Do you recognize anyone of them?
For most of them ta wul kono le mensute.
Ala ya lo mensute ka tu suto le nungung yen samba dame. Nke jele nagbari ala ya lo mensute.
I don't recognize them because it was in the night.
Ndume lomfana.
And I don't know them also.
Bari kabrin liparo kuona atafau koye kwa labula ni wontal ba falale.
When that guy came and told him to stop, otherwise they will kill me.
Nkuma tansondo moko no.
In which language?
Adi amuta kanjima leto.
No, wadi amute mandinga kawa di amute woldo. Katatika di amunyono mandinga kawa.
He spoke to them in Mandinga because he used to speak to me in Mandinga.
Kabrin woketa?
After that,
nkonsondo moko no.
I said to myself,
La ilaha illallah natalko.
La ilaha illallah has come.
Bawo to konka ole foje.
Because they said that was what I was saying there.
Imagine men fa oka fonye ba lonnal.
Don't you see even the one who was telling me you will see
wale fa oko yeko.
He was the one who told them that.
Ala kanyanta ni wontal ba falal.
Stop, otherwise you would kill him.
Na mera wo mu alala do ko damaldi.
I think that is God's doing.
Ye dendi ko murundi kan unkoto.
They put back the shirt on my head.
Yen samba bungo kono.
And took me into the house where they used to
question
people.
But
the anger and the sadness that I was experiencing and the pain from the beatings because I was bleeding from some parts of my body.
Ke kilimbe je nyina tatola le bari na nyolo na meta janimbe futala opadel kono.
There was one man that I recognized. I knew him long time before we got to the panel.
Wosondo mo matano purka nyinin ka nyinin ka jamala.
He couldn't take it to ask me many questions.
Bari yenyinin ka men na je men kuma ya ta beti.
But among the questions they asked me, the most important of all was
whether you are a
member of the UDP.
Ani ye position di male soto.
And what position do you hold?
Hanka ya hante mo UDP tendun tele mo la youth coordinator ti.
I said yes, I am a member of the UDP and I am their youth coordinator.
Katu walom purka sewo kumoka oke la pati di ya itandi.
Because on that day, to repeat those words and to show that you are a member of the party.
Watumo pisalo keta.
And at that time, I have already been humiliated.
A
lot of us were also afraid to water that they are members of the UDP party. But what I remembered again, if I am humiliated, and say that I am not a member of the UDP. Tomorrow, if I meet Ngaleng in the next world, what am I going to tell him? He will tell me that you have broken down the code of the warriors. So even if I am going to die, what I am, that's what I will remain.
Did you sustain any injuries from beating apart from the eye?
Yes,
blood was coming out from my body, and even that shirt, up to this date, they did not return it back. The shirt that I was beaten in, up to today, I have not seen it.
Could you describe what injuries you had?
Okay, bala comme deni ko le benu jeudi rombari wo ko julo yen lipo la dawo da wo yelo bondi le mbalo kon.
I had a wound on my head and other parts of my body. That truncheon, wherever they hit me, the blood used to come out of my body.
Proceed, please.
Akwete
kabiru wo keta.
After that
a man song kumo ninja biro ye me.
He would not allow a lot of questions and answers to transpire between us. And what I could make out of that situation, it was like he was sympathetic and very sympathetic about my issue. And I could also make out that if that conversation had taken longer, it could be that they'll take me back to be beaten up again. Because he knows what kind of a person I am. That was why he did not allow the conversation to take long. And he did not allow any other person to ask me questions. That was where he stopped the interrogation and told them to take me away. They put the shirt on over my head again. They took me inside the house. And I found my people there.
Especially Ibrahima Janko Sise.
I found him crying bitterly.
Ibrahim.
I said to him,
Ibrahim,
why? Just take heart, for the sake of God, a man does not behave like this. And he tells me that
they broke
two of his teeth. He had one broken teeth in his hand and he showed it to me. And said to me, my father, look at this. I said, it's difficult, it's hard, it's painful. But being a man is all about this. Let's just put God in everything.
God will favor us.
Did you see other people beaten?
No, because when they beat you and they are done, they used to bring you inside the room. But others were crying. Some you hear them screaming, but you don't get to the place where they did the beating. But what also made me angry They tell them that every day, this is what we will do to you. And I could not bear it, and I told them, it's not true. We will not return here again. They put us back onto the vehicles again like that. And they returned us to mile two.
For that group, who are tortured and brought back into the room, how many of them could you say were beaten?
No, what you can say is who's beaten is less severe than the other, but there has not been anyone amongst them who wasn't beaten. Because that day, if they can beat Nogoy, Fatou Camara,
and Fatoumata Diawara,
they will not spare any man, because if they could have the heart to beat up women, then no man will be spared.
In essence, you are suggesting that all 26 of you were beaten.
As for the student, I have not seen him beaten, and I believe that if there was anyone who was not beaten, it could be him.
Was this the only day you were taken to the NIA to be beaten?
Yes, and as God will have it, just as I said, that was the only day that they took us there to be beaten.
Could you describe the injuries of the others? You've told us about Ibrahima Janko Cisse, who was beaten, and two of his teeth were broken. You have told us that Nogoy Ndiaye, Fatoumata Diawara, and Fatou Camara were all beaten. Can you describe the injuries that you saw on the others?
Hani dolu mawol yi nga wurole moy bari nga melnu je comme même baramate ko no meye Ibrahima Janko Cisse si wonyote ko no.
There has not been anyone who got injured like Ibrahima Janko Cisse. Others, I heard their screams, but I did not see their injuries.
Did you all travel back together to mile 2?
Ya le be nati ñu la moto kilim la kana mile 2 ba.
Ani ya lon bebu ka ku moto ko no piko wol le bebu no ndui kan na nga miras nani nani ka wol no fula fula kan to le du ni piko boko no.
All of us could not get into one vehicle, so they had pickups, and I think it was four they used to take.
Atu ni mo fula handcuff ya si ni tema,
because when they handcuff two people and put them in the middle seat,
mo fula le ka si al dan na wala piko boko ko no to,
two people sit at the each side.
Doye si nyato,
one will sit at the front.
And
that was the way they were transporting us.
And when we
were going to, it was the same thing. Two people used to go into a pickup.
And those
that were escorting
them.
That was what they did to us.
The statements that you gave, did you give a confession or what happened?
Hani katu menkata droga wale kumakango sata bao ntolmanta mo kudeta la ntoltata na kamfale itandi.
No, we just narrated what happened, because we did not go to kill anybody or to stage a kudeta. We just went out to express our displeasure.
Nunjora ntentolbulu.
And we had no weapons.
Nunga menke droga wale fo.
And what we did was what we said.
Mamo kotelo nebarinte denga menke droga wale fo. Nunga wale fana asenka ibe.
I don't know about others. As for me, what I did was what I said, and that was what I said to all of them.
So Kabirim Murta na mile 2.
So when we returned back to mile 2,
Ben Sambala na Senol Kono,
and we have been taken to ourselves,
na Sponkunto Doleje,
I saw a piece of for mattress.
Katuotu Mungkuoka Kenyame.
Because that time, the way my head was, I pleaded with them to spare me that piece of mattress so that I could use it to as a pillow. One child was there.
That's
a young person, a prisoner officer who was escorting us. Was angry with me and said, why should I make such
a
and said to me, do you want us to return you back to where you are coming from? I said, but I have not said anything wrong. Just to ask that if I could have this piece of mattress to lay my head on. If you won't do it, just tell me you will not do it. But all you are saying is not necessary, and I don't think you should be saying that. I said to that individual, and if you observe, my children are older than you, and I don't think you should be saying such kinds of things to me. They returned me back to the cell, and they locked the door.
Alhamdulillah. Kabri murtan sita.
When I returned and I sat down,
nkonfaye ko ye Ibrahima Solo Sanden fale.
I said to myself, Ibrahima Solo Sanden has been killed.
Katun hakilo ya ma.
Because my mind went to him. Because they had told me that
Kabri mbota na jana incident la toni Madiana.
When we came back from the Madiana incident,
bao ena enko la nyato nko do aka fonyo na onko sa fondi ngolen katun na fa kafuta baki.
There was one NIO officer who used to address me as father because I was very close to his father. And where I was resident in Joshua, our houses were not far apart. One of my children, as we were chatting one day, said to me, well, my dad, the NIA people have said that that if I play the fool and I get into the NIA,
don't forget that
I will not leave again.
Akonyo koi koi inte falan sonko.
He said to me, they said me falai sonko.
Ani lang marong.
And lang marong.
Ani solo sanding.
And solo sanding.
Walat na kabinya je yente lipanyaming.
Which was why when I saw the way that I was beaten. And I know the amount of anger they had against Ibrahima Solo Sanden. I said to myself, they have killed Solo. Solo is not alive.
You would agree that at this time you are just speculating.
It was not just speculation, but my understanding of the situation and the way I saw things. Because that same night, the beating that was meted out to me, what about the one that was under their custody since afternoon?
But Mr. Witness, the fact of the matter is you had no first-hand knowledge of what you thought at the time.
Ya mira le drongo tembo bari nya mang sede ala kafuko yinyim fale wotembo
abari ndim fotata nyato woton kamen fo ngamira ibenna kumo jelale.
Later as we proceed, what I'm saying, perhaps you'll be able to see reason in that.
Mr. Witness, we have just set out markers at the very outset that we are not going to delve into the Solo Sanden case.
Okay.
For the simple fact that this is a matter that is in court. And it is sub judice, we shouldn't be saying much about it. But at the same time, too, we do not want to cause problems with the record. You understand?
Okay. All right, so we just steer away from that. Okay. Nyama kono folo amambano folo yo odali lole ya sabu mampare purka o silo ma wala na laftal rom pour etela ko ani eteni men mutanyala dia mobetili na ma fangolera.
You mentioned Lamine Marong.
Ye Lamine Marong fo.
And you did say that the officer, the person you spoke to before your arrest told you that the NIA officers were saying that if you and Solo Sanden and Lamine Marong got to the NIA, they would deal with you seriously or they would kill you. Is it the same Lamine Marong you're referring to as the person who was with you?
Ako ye Lamine Marong tofo. andu ñum fako mo solo ndame yalon ko me ñum fayen ko ay ñum moy ina ewul ba fa ko ite ye ñum mo do la nanu tolu fako naari dunta ina e san sama ko no koteke e ibe ku sangara kala laje wala fang yalifa so ako fo wala min maron kliw le mo fondi ngewtu bam fonte
hani hani manke otu me yo fonye o manke hani UDP di won fa manke otu bari na nyolo no dra yo kuma fonye janning demonstration o nyimbe sila.
No, he was not the one. The one who gave me this information was not even a member of the UDP. And he gave me this information well before the demonstration took place.
The question is, the person who provided you with that information, was he referring to the same Lamin Marong you when who was arrested together with you? Yes, he was the one. Did you see or did you come to learn about what happened to Lamin Marong?
Fodun inata jele wala inata amoyle ka fahamu men keta Lamin Marong na.
Hanga lonne nga fahamu katu yentel na bonne mile tu kotenke yen samba makati janjambre.
Yes, I know and I'm aware because they took me alongside him from mile 2 to janjambre.
Atela min maro yembula la mamme abanta kata fawo ka fonyo ne kabrimbe jakonyo falante be falalante balula.
We died shortly after we were released because even while we were in prison, he usually tell me falam, I will not make it, I will die.
When did he die?
Abanda wa rimale.
Kabri yembula dala mantambe kar kilim fulala afata.
Shortly after our release, not more than 1 or 2 months.
Did he die within 1 year of his torture by the NIA?
Afata watu men ina euli liparo men kala anala sayate mu ay samasi leban
ana masi katu hani kabrin tolbe prison yate admit le l'hopital quartier fayo wino electiono yate tara l'hopital ulta matra mile 2.
No, not up to a year because even while we were in prison they took him to the hospital. The election results, the time that they were being announced, that found him at the hospital, not in prison. When you think about his case, it's very sympathetic.
He did
that, we arrested. He told them that he was not feeling fine. He said so many things to them.
For yen samba makati for mursana be abajato la ko kachala drombare hani jara la masoto no mansong aita jara rola.
Since they took us to Makati and back, he constantly kept talking about his health condition, but they never allowed him the chance to go and seek for treatment.
Katu hani te fa lipo men ken na yelo be be mbalabare mansong nan jara la hani kamoje fa mansong naki.
Even me, the beating that was meted out to me and the bleeding that I was experiencing, they never allowed me to seek treatment nor to see any other person.
Mr. Witness, Lamin Marong did not die instantly. He died within a year of his torture. Would you say they killed him?
Lamin Marong, among fao no photo de fata sanji killing which you will call. But if you don't tell a mirror or go, nile a fabang.
Hana la posin kumonte man lala de barate fango die melfony.
Even the person thing he talked about, I did not believe him, but according to what he told me, the day that they were beating us at the
NIA,
they asked him to open his mouth and they put their fingers into his mouth. I said, lung. I said to him, the one that did that to you, why did you not bite off his fingers? He said to me, if I did that, they will kill me. That was why he said he was poisoned. I tried to dissuade him from that thought. But whether that is the truth or otherwise, he believed that. And God knows, he usually tells me that I will not last long, I will die. And that was how it happened.
Did you see the injuries he had on his body?
Ya jele mum barma fason le kata bala jato bala bal.
Hani ala yalo mum barma ja bala jato bala.
God knows I have not seen any injuries on his body.
And who else did you see amongst the group?
Ya jumala fananje umulu kafo ni ko no yal mel moy mutanyola.
Modu ngom fana kabri ya sambanan.
When Modu ngom was brought,
Bao na kiti follow fanye ni musolo menu samba.
because during the, our first appearance at in the court, the women that they we were taken along with.
Wale Fatumata Jawara and Fatu Kamara.
We are Fatumata Jawara and Fatu Kamara.
Wolu yewon lipale fol ketu tebulu.
They beat them until they lost consciousness.
Walat nan na first case kap lumen folon tata kiti dula.
That was why the first time that we appeared before the court.
Wal mamma be
they were not present.
Fomoli amira nun kam fol fatale.
Until people began to think that they were even dead.
Bar coming ibe jara kan nun jela ena e walat ne mawol sambana.
But it because it was because they were being treated within the NIA. That was why they were not brought.
Until the second time that
we appeared in court was when they were brought in and people saw them.
Do you know where in the NIA they were being treated?
Ha laba o kabri yembulan tata le foje yendu ni o buwo kono ko min ena en ko lu ke jara da men tata je fa o jibele.
Yeah, after we were released, we went back to the NIA premises and we were taken up to the room and were informed that this is where they treat people in the NIA premises here.
Proceed, please.
Yo sa yin kabri yemuru ni na wosuto.
When they brought us back that night, they took us back to the cells.
Cell jara kensa o matla teje femo fenteje.
Empty cell, no mattress. There was nothing in the cell.
Ayatrante konte domoro kela.
At the time, I had decided not to eat.
Nasi ma ofana beje madomo.
My dinner was there. I did not eat it.
Ye dasa mo ofana samba na madomo.
They brought breakfast. I did not eat.
Ayatranka fuyo madomo beje o meta jele.
One of my colleagues was there who's been there for a long time.
He used
to work with the Gamtel. His name is Jete. His surname is Jete. I have forgotten his first name. He came in the morning. He stood by my cell and said to me, relative. When I raised my head, I recognized him and I called out his name, Jete. I said to him, behold, you two are here. And he said to me, yes. He said to me, do you know what I want to tell you? Whatever they bring to you here, close your eyes and eat it. He said to me, if not, you will die here. That was the day that that statement of his gave me strength. I said to myself, behold, this is what Yajame wants, so that if I die here, it will become minus one for him. I said, I will not die here. I took the half loaf of bread and I took some warm water and I ate that until I completely, I ate it completely and then I drank some water. We were there that day until the evening. That same Jete came beside me and said to me, relative, he said to me, Solo Sandeng is sentenced to death.
He's beaten to death.
I said to him, no, tell me that he was beaten to death. He said to me, it's true, that was what happened. But he said to me, but I heard that there is noise at
Westfield.
That the entire Gambia was out and they were on Westfield. That was the information he gave me. The following day in the morning, I had talk amongst the people who came to the cells. They came back again. We got information that Usenu and others were brought in, and that became a fortune for us. Because the second day after Usenu and others came, I heard that he was given a mattress and beddings. They said, he said to them, the ones that you have arrested, have you supplied them with this materials? I heard that they told him no. Then he said to them, well, return back mine. If they don't have, then I don't need it. The evening of the following day,
Naje ye matlani laran kamfano ya asamanantolbe.
I saw that they brought mattresses and beddings for all of us. That was the time that I was able to sleep a little bit. Because to lie down on a bare floor, something that you are not used to in your life, God knows, for the first 2 or 3 days, I was unable to sleep.
How long did it take before they took you to court?
I waited a letter. Jani bari sambara kitola.
I think it's up to a week, if I have not forgotten.
At the court, were you allowed lawyers?
Kitio laje fe lawyer yalibula le ale lawyer ta.
Ha kitio koto lawyer nata le meni nata can defend antumange la nyatonka ya kuto siata le fan.
Yes, many lawyers came to defend us at the court, and they were led by Antumange. But the sad thing that happened that day was,
Kabirin lawyer nata,
after the lawyers arrived,
Mhakino ba kang MC Cham Dimanya di lawyer muso ni mfeleni na tatola.
I can recall MC Cham's
daughter,
a lawyer, and Amit Ben Suda and others. There were many.
Wallahi wali yodomoro men sanka sambanyena.
The amount of food that they brought for us.
Akamunu mfekoni sanji tankonkotome mandomoro ke ukamunu mfeo wala wolo.
I was like someone who has been experiencing hunger for 10 years. That day, the amount of eating that we did that day, in fact, at the end of the day, we were almost embarrassed.
How did the trial conclude?
We were
convicted and sentenced to 3 years imprisonment.
All of you?
Hani ye dolbula le katun nata janjambure.
No, some were released because all going to janjambure.
Ntolmo tani kile yole sama janjambure.
11 of us were taken to janjambure.
Pesei.
8 men.
Ani musu saba.
And 3 women.
Wodolu.
The others.
Ye mune explain what jojo ye meufanye.
What the judge explained to me was that.
Iko emang logistics soto ibe ol samba la janjambure ole nyama ye olbula.
That they did not have logistics to transport them to janjambure and therefore they were released.
Akamunda ko to isula ta menu la ye ole samba ye nkiti ni odolu ye olbula seta.
It's like they took those that they wanted to court and the others they let go. They took us to Janyambure like that, and that was the conclusion of the court.
And your trial was separate from that of Usainu Dabo and Co., was it?
Lakito ni Usainu Dabo ni amonyolo lakito fatatale.
Ha bota nyokotole katu yendol samba lefo Janyambure makati tatam soro wolto.
Yes, because we were taken to Janjambure. That was where we were imprisoned. And we had a lot of difficulty during the court process, the going and coming.
Your violation, if it was a violation at all, occurred in the Kombos, in Kanifing. Why were you tried in Janjambure?
Allah kole akulu. Ningakita, ubeketa kombo jane kani fintundoka. Muna nasila inadali samba janjambure.
Hani kanjawu ya dhu ya kewali kama katunte wa ufoye na mko ya linsamba kedugu bari janjambure suti atale.
They just wanted to be wicked to us. For me, I told them, you could take us to Kedugu. Janjambure is not far enough.
Bari kwenye unfortunately Kedugu mo Senegal leta amanke Gambia.
But they said to me, unfortunately, Kedugu is in Senegal, not in the Gambia.
But even in Banjul, it would have been out of the jurisdiction of the Banjul Magistrate Court.
Hani Banjul le fong, kule me alonko, amantara Banjulu la kiti bunda la silo koto.
Or were you tried at the High Court?
Fulu ya le kiti in the High Court.
Italia will for the commands are conquered high court no soto but they found na lo ni ngona men soto luato
but that's what they said Mansa Conko had a high court but by what the small knowledge I have about the law
ye ko ke damen dun ko be sikelo je munat ne ben sambala janjamure.
Where you commit an offense, where everything can be done there, why would they have to take us to Janjambure?
Did you serve only 3 years?
Yes, I did serve only 3 years.
Hanimma wokeje katu kabrini yang convict yang sorong Janjambure?
No, I did not serve all the term because after we were convicted and in prison at Janjambure.
Katu jefa on ala ya loni la official katu nyo sabo la ni sonko katu balambaya ya wale bembulundunga alonka ke nuntonya alekap.
Because even there, I used to have a lot of difficulty with the officers there. We used to have a lot of pushing and pulling because I was always not in agreement with them. And God knows why I was doing that. Because they were good people amongst them. There were also some bad ones amongst them. Because when they are taking me to court, taking me from Makati, coming to Mansa Conko, the vehicle that they had usually had breakdowns on each occasion. And the sad thing about the whole issue was most of the breakdowns was a result of fuel shortage.
Lack of fuel.
For Lama Jamaica, the officer in charge.
In the end, the officer in charge there. I had a prayer beads. Yeah. And you should tell me, would you not put them down now? I said, what has that got to do with the fuel, the lack of fuel? Because a vehicle that doesn't have fuel cannot move.
And then
I thought that just to make us suffer, that's why they took us to Janjambure.
So, throughout this period, from the date of your torture to the day you were released from prison, did you receive any medical treatment or checkup?
For doctor
honey,
no.
Katumem fa oyente ni okua kabrin tata Janjambure.
What saddened me when we got to Janjambure? I said to one of their prison officers that I was not feeling well. I had their medic speaking, but if he did not even see me. And he was telling him, don't mind them, they are just pretending.
How did you feel when you heard that?
To think that is a human being or someone that has blood running in his veins, I never thought of it. That was how I got angry, and I never spoke to anybody about myself, whether to say that I'm ill or not feeling okay.
After your conviction, were you allowed to receive visitors?
Yes, when we were returned to mile 2, I think after 3 months, they would issue a form which you will fill. If I have not forgotten, every month, you could give out the names of 3 individuals who could come and visit you. That was when we had people who came to visit us. I put forward the names of my 2 wives and one of my kids, and I think that kid came to visit me once.
And what were the conditions at mile 2? At the main yard.
Mile 2 la San Sambakono. Je kolu bi je nyadi le numotumo.
I take it you served your time at the main yard.
Na mira yela watu ke San Sambani ne kuno e kavla me main yard.
Hani security wing tega ke wale to ane remind wing.
No security wing and the remand wing.
But in namana dunte namana dun main yard me manamana tisa moto.
I never got to main yard. I was never taken there.
And briefly, what were the conditions?
wat kuma sutun kam madron je kolo be lari je nyaade le kolo be nyaade
hani je o kay especially remind wing
as for the place especially the remind wing
kabri en tol samba je lumen
from the day that we were taken there
dambele koto kontol nyantal lala wolto
mun koto
e ka fo je ne dambele yela on language chotle ka kuma ni nyame ka fo ne dambele duma jama ka ko ni ko je mu kabrolti kontol nyantal lala wolto
so
some say it's a grave, it's just like a grave, so it's something that has a hole under, that's where you'll go and lie down. They call it dambele.
Kati niye mira ila lara on menu fa obeye animban kotema is less than a meter.
Because if you think the beds they built there, the height of the bed is just about 1 meter.
Aman meter si?
It's less than a meter.
Dolke la santo.
Some will sleep on top.
Menu labanta na la wolka nura wole koto duma wolke la wole.
Those who come lastly will go under that bed and lie down there.
Bari ala ya kenga menu taraje.
But with the help of Allah, those who we found there.
Dolka fonte ne onkul katu ye dolyen suto ne.
Some call me uncle because some of them recognized me.
Itola la dila.
Where they sleep.
Ye wole dintola.
They allowed us to use where they used to lie down.
Itol kabin kote ke laje.
So they used to go right down under that bed and lie down there.
We have received information.
Na kibaro soto.
That the food is terrible.
Koje balu
domoro. Almost terrible.
Koje domoro sangarata baka.
Ala ya lonte domoro men dila na wulola.
God knows the kind of food that I will not give to my dog.
Kar sewo be ko ne kawali dinan ka domo.
For the 8 months, that's what they gave me to eat.
Ni o futo di le ka fo le ko fo do fo le mba fo futo le ani banko men ka tra ko no bukalo.
When they gave you the pap,
when they give you that couscous,
it comes with sand.
Hani ko la pap ni o tabaka tu yele ka tu ko le ko fo bere bere kos ba ni bukaso to ya do ni afo ka fo ni yin do be fa la janet.
As for the pap, they used to leave it there because I heard that is what give bere bere, and they tell you that when you eat that you will die.
Ni o tabi da sa mo la lu mo men na wonu na mira akatu yele ka ta bonne jama bu ka so na do men
any day that pap is cooked as breakfast, it is left lying down there and eventually they pour it out.
You did say that you did not serve your entire sentence. How did you come to be released?
Well, I lose all left at ala jonko la please
allow me, I want to go to the restroom.
Welcome back, Mr. Witness. Just to remind you, you're still under oath. So how did you come to be released?
Kabrin Karto Faita.
After the elections,
Adama Barrow Winter, His Excellency Mr. Adama Barrow Kabra Winter.
And Adama Barrow won.
Yeah, Murundin Tata Kitiola Katatra na appeal case of an Adundi.
We went back to court because we had launched an appeal.
Kabrin Tata yeah, released on bail.
When we went back, we were released on bail.
I think
our release came about just like that, by what I understand.
So you were released on bail?
Yes.
So there must have been a stay of execution of the sentence.
Hanga mira ni manyi na namusola ID card je hanika ba mabula katu yembe belle wolum ID card so lel sambanang yembe.
My wife's ID card is still there up to this date because it was their ID cards they brought to bail us.
And what were the conditions of the bail?
Belo ni ya la sarta fason ju manyol le kan
na mira ko le gambia dim fula dro menu ya ID card soto o kile ni manyi na nyim fulol dal ko menu ya ID card soto wolle belle oke.
I think they said the two Gambians or one who had ID cards.
And when were you to return?
Ni kwali simru wati juma.
Hanata muru kitio tole kotenke bari mhakilo manama katusani dola kakawa kuyale ngamira nende dukol kakana.
We returned back to court later, but I can't remember because sometimes
it
I lose
the case
network.
That because UDP won the elections or the coalition won the election, the trial became insignificant or unimportant.
Munta Green Carto Fight of Kapare, why the UDP Lenata Carte Fayoni Ngani?
Coalition.
Coalition, sorry. Coalition, Olem Denna, Patio Lakafunyomo, why the Wilenata Ngani? What was Silang Akonin Amana Kumaya Baka, Muntadal Akonin Nakulia Jolonta Oleto?
Hani Kitty Mansoron, Sembo Lenson, Nuato, Alai Sembo Karapamena, Sembo Tabulu Koteng.
No, we were not imprisoned by the court. It was power that imprisoned us, and that person is no longer in power.
Were you released by the court, or were you also released by power?
Yali Kitu Bunda Lealibula for Sembo Lealibula.
Ni aji ben kitio woto mune beson na kabrin de wani manso yembel muna atina saa kabrin karto faita sembo be membulu sembe tabuli sonta yembel.
Mr. Witness, answer the question. We are not arguing.
Okay.
The question is, were you also released by power and not by the court?
Akwa ni alimandra ya nyosabala akubari abebenyi ninkakang. Kiti bundale alibula fosembole alibula.
Ha, kiti bundale mbula.
Yes, it was the court that
you were put on bail.
Munda yali,
according to
bail
you.
Ha.
Yes, yes.
Mm-hmm. But the bail was not respected.
Pari bailo nying bunyaman na atarakan.
Lumebe mbula labangu bailo.
You mean the day that we were released?
How did this conviction and this sentence came to be off your head, off your neck?
Say, bring kito keta ye surundiro men lekan aning ye kafolua ye muta. Anata boye kango kuna nyadila, labute kuna nyadile.
Kabri yembe lenga nonka butang kuna, kabri yembe.
It was after we were built, that was when I knew that the burden was off my head.
Mr. Witness, a bail does not occasion the extinction of a sentence.
A common falling in the cafe a bill. Ubuka can the surrounding a boy kunade.
Hanamira natamuru kitio kunale cabrin belo nim bantala barrio kitio nga miraiko inata nimanyinaiko man soron luakan. Yembula wolefe nimanyina nga miraole.
I think we returned back to court after the bill, and in that court it was declared that we were not imprisoned by law.
It does not look like you can recall things being done properly under the
law.
Hani katunga mira ko sembo yen soron wala bawe bari man soron lua kan.
No, because I believe we were imprisoned through force and not by law.
But even in that situation, if you are to be released, you should be released pursuant and in accordance with the law.
Bari hani ina tali bula, wobula ro nyanta kela nyaming, anyanta tala ni silolela ani kolua ya itandi nyaming, ishali bula ka kundi kolua la kamole ya sabu ya libula.
But I wouldn't burden you further with these issues.
Bari ntebata nila kuteke nyinkumolula.
Thank you very much.
Inumbara baake.
Thanks for answering my question.
Inumbara yana nyinkarulu bejabi.
Okay, Baraka.
Over to you.
Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Emma Council, and thank you very much, Emma Fallon Sonko. Testify before the commission.
Chairman ko Council Numbara bitu itafana Lamin Fallon Sonko ako Numbara.
So you had to suffer so much in the hands of agents of the state.
Ako ise haketo yebata bata ki banko fola du kulalu bulu.
Was the case brought to a closure? I'm just following up on the council's question on that particular point.
Ako kitoni inata akumosoro na kafu kitoni mbandala banko lead council yenye ninkanu mena.
Hanga wale mera ngamira kabri murta kitio lang mhakilo manjele muta nobari ngamira ko ye kitio nyin banne ko ye mbulale mfritale mansoro ye sorondro menkena ani lua mantani mhakilo bama ala ngamira wale kita.
Yes, we returned back to court after the bail, but I cannot remember what transpired in that return that we made. But I think what the court said was that our imprisonment was unlawful and that we were released and we were free to go.
What was the court's final pronouncement on the case, if you can recall that?
Mi hakilo sibulala kiti bundala kumakala bango ye kalimu mfale wale akawale nyirika.
Hakino tamala katu watumu wasia wale bekeri mpisalo ketanto buka mira kiti kula kutengi.
I cannot recall because at that time we were joyous and no one was thinking about going to court anymore.
Well, they could revoke the bail, bail and then send you back.
Kwezi kitu nyi, isi belo nyi senka mamandile kuteke yali murundi.
Hakatu ila ukumwode asikeno le katunga mo la minjata fa onka fuko adama baro nyanta usenu murundi la prison le brate hakilo mama ko ani usenu bebe le prison le nie usenu murundi prison frate tula bantako.
I your statement we'll,
okay, we'll come back there. Commissioners, if you have any questions, I'm deputy chair, you have the floor, please.
Chairman Lolanko wale lafte nyinkala.
Thank you very much, chair. Thank you, Mr. Sonko. Thank you, lead counsel.
Chairman Numbara, I lead council Numbara. Mr. Sonko, I fanan Numbara.
Just one simple question. What happened to your car?
Ako nyininkare solo ya renkili mune nata kila motola.
Na motode yensoro nyame ya fanasoro wole nyame. Fokabri yambula.
Well, my car, the same way as I was imprisoned, was the same way that my car was imprisoned until when I was released.
Kabri yambula le natana moto nyindina, NIF, ya dina ulto found.
After I was released, they gave me back my vehicle at the NIA.
Bao amanna fano kutenge katu kabri ya dina atinyari wale ngamira hani kabri woku labanda sambala kiti otole.
Because when they gave it back to me, it was no longer useful to me. It was in a very bad shape. I think I even took the matter to court.
What was the outcome of the court case?
Sila mbili ya kuwa samba kitu wala na atala wanyarile.
Hani katu kuwa bata mbidi faole kwenye kono a withdraw court ntolba akuwa setu lale out of the court katu. Ifango dabe mansa kundame nkono ya miresi wala samba no kitu wala bansonta.
Bata mbidu suggested to me to withdraw the case and they will look into the matter because if you are a part of a government, it's not going to be smart or wise to take that same government to court.
TRRC set up,
and when the TRRC was established,
akonye kosanye nga kuwe be samba wato yeta wolba kuwe handle lale.
He said to me, I have forwarded the matter to it, I go there and they will handle the matter.
Nga mire tolpa wale letter osa fal tolien no ya samba nanjang.
I think they wrote a letter to you and brought it here.
Katunga na copy sotole.
Because I have my copy.
Barijaye nata afonye ko.
But then they said to me that,
hadama ya nyanto ntol kapula wale noma.
They were only after human rights abuses.
Bari jo ila jorango o ila fengo ye mentai bulumbu kabula o noma.
But your property that has been taken away from you, they are not following that.
Isamba kiti yola.
Take them to court.
Murta na lawyer ya.
I return back to my lawyer.
Abe kaito lida kane.
He is preparing the documents.
Rumye samba kiti yola.
So that I could take them to court.
Bari nalo afana mampare polo katu kiti kubuka solo ya.
Because I know that he is not ready yet because matters of the court and
bari
the policy.
Sanyi wotembo to wobe wotembo leta abe lori wotu.
But that is where the case is now, the stage of preparing documents to go to court.
Thank you very much.
Okay,
thank you
too.
But your car was not bailed.
Bari mera moto bailed.
Akon na moto mam?
Bari mera moto bailed.
Ima kinyadi?
A bail, ka bail.
Ka bail.
Eh, to from a bail nyami moto mam bail o nyadi.
Ah, ikal bail kada kitola.
Ah, yase nimal de bitumalo yasoro nyami bari yase nimal.
They returned it back to me. I don't know how they imprisoned it.
And it wasn't tortured.
Are kuimo moto fa nambute.
Eh ya butele ko bawo ya fadati nyal.
Because they spoil it.
There are no further questions. Mr. Songo, if you have any final remarks to make, please proceed to make them now.
Nyinkar kotati je wari commissioner tije mbe nyinkara. Bitu ta no mbela kacha kum fara menna. Mr. Songo, fana sitente yo kumolfo.
Ah okay, menna kacha kum fara menna malo munatinna. Ntela interview alma kono fanu ni purka kujama soto mulubara. Alhamdulillah ngamira mionku mayata albila lafta memoela alio moele. Barimbaka nuna numbake nga kujama kono fanu ni tusanyimua ni mfulo kono ndunta mena bari. Alhamdulillah. Kukili ndorong?
Mbatu, niya jamfandu nya kalnasoro bukule harali.
Ah, ok. Mko njina talto lakura. Alkatu doli nende tuko lukatari.
Mkona. What he is saying is that, well, thanks to Allah and thanks to the Commission. Between a follow kuke by ya for Yemen Bela and Yukan Yadumanduman Sata.
Habao tala Ibrahim Sandem akamem for Yenu.
Because the late Ibrahim Sandem, what he used to tell me.
Akonye koning tantang almenye tantang okumandi.
He told me that people who called for a drumming session.
Ninduo diata.
And if the drumming session becomes very enjoyable, they forget the people who call for the drumming session. And I think that's the stage we are now presently in. Because those who knew that there is death in front of this whole thing, but those people took Allah and they decided to wait for death. Even healing or treatment,
one more little kanjara.
It is other people who help us to treat us.
The
person whom you know that we are all in the same organization, we were all fighting the same thing. If you think. If that person becomes the leader,
hani manku koten soto.
Even if we cannot achieve anything else,
bari najara ro.
But our treatment, medical treatment,
na miranyanta ukelenu wala sulotile.
I think he should be very busy to make sure that we get medical treatment.
Hani manku koten soto bari sijara ro soto.
Even if we cannot get anything else, but we should be treated.
Bari jara ro fango.
But even medical treatment,
alaya along.
Allah knows. It is outside people and other people who help us to treat us. Because so that's why I think the late Solo Sunday, what he used to say is what has happened. When the drumming session became enjoyable, they forgot about us.
But alhamdulillah, man ni misa faradin te den kuma man ni misa.
But thanks to Allah, me, I am not regretting anything. Because I did it for my country. And the reason why I did it,
alhamdulillah,
thanks to Allah, that happened. Because me, within the 22 years, we were doing politics.
hanin prali la announcement.
Even to announce our rallies.
Mukadula sotomba fola dame.
We don't have anywhere to announce it.
But be alhamdulillah.
But today, thanks to Allah.
Political party will be kata radio to lebe la kumaka will fola.
All political parties are given chance to talk about their politics over radio stations.
Amuta lipa fa soronga yemandi.
Catch him, beat him, kill him, let him disappear has all stopped.
Naji kiko Gambia di wal beka futa nyomale ngao kele wopatajang.
I think the whole of the Gambia came together, we stopped that, it has stopped in the country.
Nunga loneko hani tariko kono niba satala.
And I know that even if it is been to be narrated in history,
molu jaw yata nyaonya,
however bad people become,
but solo Sunday April 14 nala molu,
but solo Sunday for April 14 and his people
nalo nyimbanko tariko be safela dawoda.
I know that wherever they write the history of this country,
hani manto dundije,
even if our names are not mentioned,
but hakil malu woltenyina lanna,
but people who has good minds will not forget us. Because of that, I don't feel very unhappy about it. Because the reason why I got up, even if some people died during the course of that struggle, but the reason why we started the struggle, even those who didn't have any, who didn't suffer during the struggle are now enjoying it. And that's way, that's the way how development of a country goes along. Because in many cases, those who died in the course of fighting or those who came, who encountered serious problems, usually you don't enjoy
the aftermath.
But thanks to Allah, your own children, your grandchildren, and other relatives will enjoy the aftermath. So that's why I said I don't regret anything. But there is one thing which really made me unhappy. Because yesterday what we all fought and said that will not happen in this country.
But alias afa alaja alko never again.
But you wrote it here as a slogan, never again.
But akamunta ko ku kilimo.
But it looks like that same thing
ha amanjam fade
is not far away.
What on Manteo City?
But if we don't get up and tie our waists, we might go back into the same problem again.
What on naya marlo be kalamenti banku dingol be.
Well, so my advice to the whole nation, let's all do it for the sake of Allah.
Excuse me, Mr. Witness. I hope you would understand. Just give your statement relative to what has happened. And be mindful of the sensitivities of not using this as a political platform to rally your political supporters. We have never had to make such an intervention. But in view of the situation, we just want to avoid politicizing the work of the TRRC.
La fitale, TRRC la duko politiko hani tondo kanabula akono.
But that said, it's your closing statement. We don't want to gag you. Say what you believe is appropriate for the Gambian people to hear at this stage.
Si fem fo me yalonko wole be bete ala Gambian ko liye men se ke kayra koti nyin tembe.
And if you want to carry out with your party politics,
ni lafta ila party politiko lutamandila,
there would be better fora to do that.
Dinkralo be kerine di isiwo lutamandilo dami.
And I hope you would understand.
Bitun ngamira ibem fahamula le ngafo dalilo men kam.
Thank you. Uson tangaje fahamula.
I agree and I understand that situation. What I am appealing to the whole nation is
ninte falan sonko,
mi falan sonko,
yemen kenna
what has been done to me
nin sinina no abela
if I can forget all
kabadi ya sunkuru nin mobe tema
to reconcile with everybody
woto ngamira mobe nyanta okeno lale
I think everybody should try and do that
na banko do yatale
our country is very small
ntolel bota baklim fakli
we are all from the same mother and father
ndun tolle fana ndamali nyolo na mansia ka fuko mankari long hani wo mansia ja
it is not so much that you will say I don't know so and so I don't know so and so we are all the same people
ndamalel ka futu nyoye
we are the same people who marry for each other
ndun ndamalel ka kuke nyoye
and we are the same people who do things for each other
what on now body ya
so that relationship
alinka na song
let's not agree
lead council yemem for politico kana otinyanda malte
what lead council said let's not allow politics to destroy that good relationship between us
bawo political wol kana le katabar gambia o betula janne
because politicians come and go but the gambia will always remain here
what on nabadi ya alinga omuta
so let's please try and reconcile and build up our good relationship
men fana boita molukan
those who also offend people
dukarembe fana danile kana ke hadani roti yeson ko to leboita molkan ngam haka bonyoye ngake baklin faklin
those who offended people who adversely mentioned please I'm appealing to them let them just agree so that people will try and forget we will come together and become the same mother and father again
anyway wala munna kumoti
that's ma what I have to say
me banko di wobe danila wala
I'm appealing to the whole Gambian nation for that
ni note keno la barinsi yamfu no nyoyenne
people may not forget but we can forgive each other
naka na ke banko la nyatuta kama
let's do it for the sake of the development of the country
mbenga dem baklim faklina
we all should join one mother and father
na muru nyokan
let's come together reconcile
ngamira wole ben sambala nyato
I think that's the only way we can take us forward
alanyin TRRC fana
this TRRC
kube bolaje kute bolaje
whatever comes later whether they will bring justice or not
no to alabulu
let's leave that in the hands of Allah
bawo jale commission tambita janne
because jale commission happened here
jamaka fuko kuma boje nyundo fana kute bolaje
a lot of people are saying that nothing came out of the jale commission and TRRC also nothing will come out of it
barina ala dani drone
but we are appealing to Allah
alo tangani yomen kama
the reason for the establishment of the TRRC
for city mano
so that can be achieved
habari council fana kamen fo
but what council also said
akambali menna
what he prevented me from doing or saying
akadolu nyinin kajanne
he asked some people
na botaje kate faone
if they live here they insult him
ndi manyin commission wuli wakama oy malo kama
and this commission was not established because of that
tonya du nabe fola
and if the truth is going to be established
fire boy mo kande
somebody must have to be stained
barika alay mulle mutaye son tonyala
but always be and believe in Allah and take the truth
bar wole hadamadi yakole yakatu dolbe je hannin tonya be la karole bukaso
that's what made humanity difficult now because even if they see the truth they will not agree
mbe duala mobe simane njata kendea
I'm praying for everybody to get long life and good health
mbe duala mbe mobe danela fana ye duam fana ye simane njata kendea
I'm also appealing to everybody to pray for me to get long life and good health
katu dolum balo kama mfe nyame
because sometimes how I feel my body
ala damale olo
it's only Allah who knows
bare tumando be dua fana ka kodo jarale
but sometimes prayers also heal certain things
mbe duala mobe simane njata kendea
I'm praying for everybody to get good long life and good health
mbe duala na musu fulol fanaye
my I'm praying for my two wives
ye munyoni sabaro menta
the patients they had
animbadi ngol fana
plus my relatives
mbe duala ol fanaye
I'm praying for them too
bawo karise ye mutome mbe kenna
because the 8 months I stayed in detention
ninte hakilo bakan
if I can remember
UDP party men din na dimbala manta mi dalasi wulinanila
what the UDP party gave to my family is not more than $4,000
barin koto ma men keta maja sonkoti
but my elder brother maja sonko
ala yalo
ala nos
na musol ko karo kari
my wife said every month
mani boto ani wuli sabakemelula ka wole di momole kono
he gives them a bag of rice plus
$3,500 plus a bag of rice. That's what he gives to each of my wives.
Ake ko la nganyanta kala lebar wo fanata ti namba fula mo benya la ko animbara ya baraka.
There's something he should do, but I will say this in the presence of everybody, my sincerest thanks to him.
Anina dinke ba me fana be America be karangola.
Plus my eldest son who is also going to school in America.
Katu kabri be motala tra ya la first degree ke bare hanika ba mala masters ke no kata ye fanyo karangola le aya nyatilin do ko la pourka do ko fasa na banyol.
By the time I was arrested, he stopped going to school so that he can walk and try to sustain his younger brothers and the whole family when I was in detention. I'm praying for him also, plus his younger brothers, for Allah to grant them long life and good health.
Meduala banko mol fanaye alinga sabarota alinga munyota ngamuru alaka ngasonto nyala.
I'm praying for the whole country. Let's be patient. Let's bear. Let's return to Allah and try to take this land forward.
Meduala alto commissional fanaye doku bale balkanga koleata dimete bare alimbenga alatanga munyoni sabarota.
My prayers to the commissioners and the whole commission. What I say is, let's also have faith in Allah and be patient.
Meduala mobe simani njata kendane harje fingola animanta bemo.
My prayers to everybody, for Allah to give us long life, good health, and progress.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Mr. Sonko.
Inu mbarabake, Mr. Sonko.
Yes, for coming to testify before the commission.
Sonta kana sele aro la commission nyati lula.
And for your final remarks.
Inata kumakan kendo lumenfu kela kumukumfa.
And so before I come to you on two procedural points, the deputy wanted them to say a word on medical treatment, as he said. Please go ahead.
Thank you, Chair. The witness raised the issue of the government not providing medical treatment for people who had suffered physical harm. I would want to put on record here that the TRRC is called the Truth, Reconciliation and Reparations Commission. And under the Reparations Commission, there is a committee which addresses issues that you have raised. There is a policy. The regulations have been drawn and will soon be gazetted. But any victim or any complainant that comes to the TRRC and goes to the victim center, the victim support unit is assessed for their health needs, whether it is emotional, physical, or mental. The psychosocial unit gives a lot of support in providing psychosocial support and care, not only to the victims, but to their families as well. In terms of urgent interim reparations, the medical board set up by the Ministry of Health has been assessing patients that need medical treatment, whether at the local level or if the type of care is not available in the country, they make recommendations that the patients should be treated abroad. Working under the recommendations of the medical board, the TRRC has sent 4 patients to Turkey. They went last December. 3 of them have returned, and 1 is still in Turkey. And even though the medical treatment was supposed to be free under the agreement with the Turkish government, maintaining those patients in Turkey has cost the TRRC well over $11 million. So it is not that the TRRC is not taking care of the needs of people who need medical help support. As we speak, we have got 3 patients in Senegal who went for surgery. Their surgery has been successful. We are looking forward to receiving them at the end of the month. For those who are being treated at the local level, their medicines and other aids that they need, like glasses, wheelchairs, etc., are all provided for by the TRRC. Maybe these are things that the public do not know. Please, I would urge you to go to the victim support if you need medical care. And I can assure you that if the medical board assesses your case, the TRRC will address it. The good thing about this is we are doing it while we are sitting, while we are still in office. At the end, we will be able to roll out final reparations, but the urgent interim measures are being done not only for medical support, but for educational support. We've got we've returned several children back to school, and also for livelihood support. I cannot dwell a lot on the livelihood support, but I know that apart from the, how do you call it, the tool that NAPAM had supported, the livelihood support that over 16 women got is quite considerable. So we are trying to get people to stand back on their feet. So please, just know that this support is available and make use of it. Thank you, Mr. Witness. Thank you, Chair, for giving me the opportunity.
Thank you, Deputy Chair. And Chair is also the chairperson of the Reparations Committee. Thank you for that update on reparations and the medical treatment and what the TRRC is doing. Council, yes, if you can do that. What Commissioner Kinte is whispering to me would reveal it, but is it 100 million? They gave them
government has
hold on a second.
100 million.
50 million.
No, 50 and 50. 100.
Did the 50, did the second 50 come?
The government has given an initial amount of 50 million. They have pledged to give an additional 50 million, and they will give it. But that, of course, is not enough to cover. If I've just told you that just maintaining people in Turkey has cost us over 11, so we have now reached out not only to the diaspora, but to the private sector as well, and to all Gambians to support the reparations program of the TRRC, because it is our collective responsibility.
Well,
thank you.
I don't want to turn the commission into a fundraising
but
that's all right. Council, you have two procedural points.
Yes, Mr. Chair, I was to give you exhibit numbers.
Oh, yes, indeed.
For two documents that were used during the Lieutenant General Langton Bongtamba testimony. And first is the letter of appreciation to Professor His Excellency Sir Professor Alhaji Dr. Yahya A.J. Jaija Mebabili Mansa, and that would be Exhibit 180A. And the newspaper interview with the Daily Observer, that is XCDS Tamba, prison brought me closer to Allah, that should be Exhibit 180B. Thank you, Mr. Chair. A. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you very much. This brings us up. Oh, Council, are we getting the next number witness on that as you as we
My witness is here, Mr. Chair, but I do want to believe that we are well over the time. So next session.
Okay, fine. This brings us to the end of the proceedings today. And we are going to have some activities that are not related to public hearings within the next few days. We will resume public hearings on the 28th of December. But thank you all very much, Emma, for coming, and wish you all the best. And we see you back here on the 28th. Thank you very much. Meeting is adjourned.